Welcome to the Cats Motel. I'm Cats. Will you please sign in?
Welcome to Tales of Zestiria, the action JRPG that asks, are oranges the only fruit? And answers, yeah, probably. So, we are at the final DOS, who I have attempted to defeat about 3 times, but haven't been able to, despite being able to beat the hardest optional DOS in the game on my second attempt. A lot of that is down to a DPS check that we'll see later.
We're here. Yeah.
Sorey, no matter what, all of us are here behind you. Never forget that.
So, there you have it.
Let's kick some ass!
Thanks, guys. For everything. Time to bring an end to all of this. Let's go.
The two of them haven't once mentioned their gramps ever since we entered Camlon.
True. Perhaps they mean to show him that it won't do him any good to bring harm to Zenris.
I don't know. Looked to me like they're just scared. Like they're afraid to acknowledge their weaknesses.
Come on!
Gildulf! It's time to settle this!
A world where all who live know pain. It is indisputable that every creature yearns to be liberated from this senseless suffering. Why do you fight back, Sheperd?
It may be that the world you strive for would free us all from suffering and anguish. But I still don't think it's the right solution.
We don't want to avert our eyes from pain.
Only in knowing hardship can we celebrate and feel enlivened in the good times.
That's right. We want to be able to feel that we're alive.
The peace that only comes from fighting against suffering. Surely you don't think the world should consider that a blessing.
We're not saying it's a bad thing to run away from it.
Just that we don't plan to do that.
I merely speak of the laws of nature.
You mean to live is to obey the laws of nature?
What else would it be?
You're wrong. All that is not being dead. You, of all people, ought to know just how painful that can be.
Let me ask you one more time, Sheperd Sorey. Join me.
Never!
The Lord of Calamity and the Sheperd, so they are this world's light and dark. But I will not succumb to light!
I won't give in to darkness! Get ready, everyone!
We must draw Maltellus' powers out from here.
Otherwise, we'll never be able to identify their bond.
Got it!
Let's get some speed up in here.
Ready?
I've
got the
plan!
Quickly! Ready?
No
escape! Quickly!
No escape!
Okay.
No matter how strong you get, you cannot abandon the one who raised you.
Sorey?
Reverend Ian Paisley?
Gramps!
What?
You said you wouldn't give in to darkness. Then what is it you feel this very moment?
Is absorbed Senris?
Sorey, step back!
Lailah, if we purify him, we can save Gramps, right? Lailah! Gramps!
Do you feel it? The pain of hurting one's beloved children?
Heldulf!
Go on, save him if you can.
Offer your protection. Oh. Ready? Gramps! Gramps!
You monster! Just kick his ass! Then we can talk!
I can get behind that.
Yeah, if we just wail and moan, we're sunk.
I thought you had a way to sever the bonds of hell. Why aren't you using it on me?
I knew he was plotting something, but...
This is worse than using Zenos as a hostage.
Chill out, Faye.
Saving your guardian will require you to sacrifice your comrades. But if you use it now, you'll never defeat me. It's quite the quandary, isn't it, Sheperd?
Held up. How could you?
He's summoning other aliens. That's not fair. No, as a like rock ground type, Edna really should be like immune to Helldell's lightning attack. Also, wow, I should do like Pokemon teams for all of these characters.
You understand now how meaningless it is to resist?
You know more than anyone what it is to suffer. How could you inflict that same pain on other people?
I didn't become this way by my own hand. It was you. Your sins!
Shut up! I'll never let you have your way!
Do this.
But Rose, please, there must be some other way.
You can't stand the thought of losing your own family. Isn't that precious?
Screw you! Gramps, Muse, none of them would have had to die if it weren't for you! It's all your fault!
Yeah, you're not the ones who suffered. Foolish decision.
So, what will you do?
I'll work it out somehow! That's what I promise!
This is not the place for a squire.
Myself. Thank you, Rose, for everything.
Sorey! Idiot!
Sorey. Stand back, everybody!
I won't let you carry this by yourself.
You're not fit to save anyone!
Loose raw brulee!
You know full well the rules,
He means well, and that's the very reason.
You idiots!
I know. It all depends. I humbly accept. You're too
small. And live your life to the fullest. And I know you will not go astray.
Christ. I won't forget this pain. Ever!
Sorey, Mikleo, well done.
Your resistance is such that you would dirty your own hands? So be it. I shall grant you true loneliness. Bartellus! Your resolve. Before me, all of it is worthless.
No turning back for either of us now. If we did, it would negate everything we've ever done. Isn't that right, Heldol?
Think not to lecture me, urchin.
Fearless Charge! Strike! Dragonless! Fearless Charge! Sorey, remember, we can only afford to use it four times.
Fire up at him while armatized as...
Yeah, I know.
The ultimate attack!
Make sure you pull the trigger when he stumbles so you don't miss!
It'll take stones to pull it off. Can you handle it?
I'll be supporting you too! We can do it, Sorey!
Yeah!
Well, speaking of, look at Heldaf. He's so cute. I want to stroke his mane. He hits really hard though. Okay. Right, that phrase is first sign that he's about to launch a DPS check. Well, basically he'll charge an attack and we have to do a certain amount of damage before he fires. Or you can do it just after he fires. But it's not recommended, but I'll reduce you down to 1 HP. So, I'm going to change everyone's strategy. Okay, so Rose is equipped entirely with Green Slasher, which does a lot of damage very quickly. Yeah, so she's on semi-auto. For some reason, we can't switch characters.
Thou dwellest in the depths of despair.
Okay.
You know what to do, Sorey.
I'm counting on you all. Eldar, the wind that shall lead the way. The time is now. Zestiria!
Okay. Now. Okay, she's back on auto. Looks like she'll go to semi-automatic naturally if we switch to her. Time to set everyone's strategy back. Put everyone on survival first. And they can decide if to use the last or not.
How cruel and thoughtless of you. You have given up someone you called a friend. And what has it earned you? Nothing. A meaningless death.
Now that first DPS check is usually really easy. They get progressively harder each time. So we'll see how that pans out. No, actually, we won't. This is also the point where Heldal starts using status effects, which aren't usually much of a problem on their own, except they stop us from using items on the affected character. Apart from Panacea bottles, which we then have to use before the main characters are. Like, he's not used any status effects yet, but he will eventually. Okay. once again. Change everyone's strategy.
This extends to the depths. Thou dwellest in the depths of despair. Thou art but void and nothing.
Okay.
Now go, Sorey.
The strength of an Earth Titan!
Oh, by the way, after using each one, we lose that Seraph. Because they're inside held up now. Need to change everyone's strategy again. I think this is the only battle where I've had to just constantly switch up everyone's strategy. Now the next one will be the real test. Like the next DPS check. Because that is usually where I start falling down. And then I found the last one. Just impossible. So everyone has better equipment now. Because the last time I tried this, it was pretty dark turtles. So everyone was several levels lower and Rose didn't have her orc blades. Okay. Fast. Go all out. I'm actually getting quite tense now. Because the last time I tried this, I got past the CPS check, but he had already fired, so they were all down to 1 HP. Okay, that was a lot better.
Your squad no longer armatized. This is the end.
Don't be so sure.
As you can see, though, this one is a problem.
We were ready for this
because now we're down a party member. Also held out flying. We won't keep flying. Or just do it occasionally to irritate us. Not wrong now. He actually hasn't used any status effects for this battle. I keep mispronouncing status. He hasn't used any status effects this battle, which is odd. Right. I actually never changed from that. Okay. Ooh, that's fine then. Symbolism.
Last one!
Raging winds! Raging winds! Back off!
Weakling.
It's time!
Weakling! Underestimated! Weakling!
Shatterbang! Try this on! Be gone! No escape!
Weakling!
This isn't over! I won't!
What?
Destruction! Weakling! Weakling!
Cup room!
Underestimate!
Fluencer! Quick server! Hit! Hit!
Weakling!
Hit!
Weakling! Underestimate Weakling!
Evil be gone! Here! I'll give my all!
Weakling! Destruction!
Back it up!
Move! Weakling! Underestimated!
Ready, Weakling! Yeah. Beast Thunder! Kendrick Flint!
Weakling! Yeah. Weakling!
Now tell us.
You've achieved your goal. You've avenged your guardian, your comrades. This age of chaos will not end. And when you put that sword through me, a new Lord of Calamity will be born. Only then will you fully understand.
I'm sorry that this was the only way to save you. Good night, Heldolf. Your life of eternal solitude is at last over.
You dare fight back, even until the very end. I can't stand it.
Thank you.
Well, that was Tales of Zestiria, the Zestiria section JRPG. Don't know if there's any post-credits scene, so we'll cheerfully sit through what will be a very long set of credits. This was a let's play I wanted to do for a while before I actually ended up doing it. Sophie, played by Kana Hanazawa, one of my favourite voice actors. I originally didn't because Bandai had one hell of totally unenforceable, actually, EULA, which put me right off. But I eventually just kind of decided that it's not enforceable in any capacity, so I may as well ignore the EULA, which basically stated that Bandai can take any Let's Play you do and use it for their own purposes at any time. Decided, might as well ignore it, crack on with it, it'll be good and fine. And it was good and fine. Not my favourite game, I played it with the channel, but I did enjoy it. Now, there is actually a DLC for this, come to think of it, which is apparently very short, like short enough I could finish it in one or two parts, and takes place after this, following Alicia. So I might do that. In fact, I probably will do that, but maybe not for a while. Because I want to do Tokyo Twilight Ghost Story next. When I want, and after that, if there's time, I'll do the DLC, but I want to do Valkyria Revolution as soon as it comes out, really. And I've got various other things lined up for a year. I want to do Danganronpa another episode. I want to do Danganronpa V3 when that comes out in autumn. And I would quite like to do Dark Rose Valkyrie. Again, I only found out about quite recently. But which kind of combines Tales-esque RPG shenanigans with Danganronpa pick out the killer in a class trial shenanigans, and that sounds interesting enough to catch my attention. And that is... it's that die. It's... no, I don't recall. Not a dev or a publisher that has ever been featured on this Let's Play channel before, so it'll be a new experience. But yes, if you've not seen it already, I'm doing Trails of Code Steel right now, which is kind of Valkyria Chronicles meets Tales of Zestiria as raised by Persona 4. It's the best way I can think to describe it. And it's good. I'm liking it. Much like this, much like anything, it's not perfect, you know? But it is very enjoyable. Regrettably, it was on a 2-episode-a-week schedule, and I wouldn't really like it to be 3 episodes a week. But it's going to remain that way for basically the foreseeable future, I should think. Because, you know, stuff. Because I want to get Tokyo Twilight Ghost Story done quite quickly, and I want to give Valkyria Revolution kind of mainline status, if you will. So it goes. I can't skip through any of... I can't even fast forward these credits. So I might just cut out a bunch of footage. Now there is an anime series of this game too. Tales of Zestiria X. Which appears to be a very loose adaptation. It has the same characters and the same broad plotline, but it heavily diverges in the details. To the extreme degree, to kind of mark itself out as its own original property, and also to try and just distinguish itself from this and to fix some of the flaws. So I'd be interested to see what that's like. Post-credit scene. Oh hey, these guys all survived. There's a new Sheperd. And more credits. Oh god, it was a mid-credit scene. So had me idolizing held out there. I should have expected this. Game credits are always really long, and there might be a scene after it. These images are adorable, by the way. Ooh, post-credit scene. Damn, Mikleo. Oh, so Sorey sleeps for ages, but does eventually return and reunite with Mikleo. That's a pretty happy ending. I'm good with that. Well, that is the end of that Let's Play, the end of the series, DLC notwithstanding. So, please, like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I will see you for another game.